Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at signing up for a Game Center account on an iOS device. So Game Center is Apple's high scoreboard and achievement system, and it can be used by all sorts of different apps on your iPhone, iPad, and iPod Touch. Now, the advantage of using it is that instead of having to sign up for a different leaderboard system with a different user account and ID and password and all that for each game that you play, you can use your Apple ID and have that across all the different accounts. Now, some games use separate systems and some games use something like Facebook to track the high scores and have you sign in. But a lot of them, more and more every day, are using Game Center. So it's worthwhile to sign up for a Game Center account so you can access those features of the game. So if you've never used Game Center before, then you probably want to start off by just going into the Game Center app to sign up. Here's the Game Center app. I'm going to jump into that. And you can see here it starts off blank, and you have to enter an Apple ID and password. Now you should use your existing Apple ID. This is the same as your iTunes account ID. It's the one used for everything else having to do with Apple, such as iCloud. So you want to use that. You don't want to create a new one unless you absolutely don't have one, because it gets very complex if you have multiple Apple IDs for multiple services. So just use the one that you've gotten. Sign up. So after you entered your ID and password, you tap sign in. You accept the agreement. And then you create a nickname. And this is what other people will see you as when you compete with them in games or list your high scores on high scoreboards. Now you have some choices to make. You can make your profile public so others can find you inside of Game Center. This helps if you want to kind of build a group of people that you play against or challenge each other. Then you can accept whether or not you get game invites so friends can actually play a new game and then challenge you at it and invite you to the game. Also nearby invites for people that are located near you. You can use contacts to get friend recommendations. So this will basically then say, here are some of friends that already signed up with Game Center. Now you can send them friend invites. So that's it, done. And then it will save. And you can also here use Facebook to find friends that you're friends with on Facebook that are signed up with Game Center. So you probably want to do most of that because you want to have a group of friends that you can compare scores with and challenge. Otherwise, when you look at high scoreboards, all you can do is compare yourself to the rest of the world. It's going to be hard to compete with the rest of the world. But it can be a lot of fun to compete with a group of, say, 100 or so friends from Facebook and your contacts. So next here, you can add a status, kind of how you're doing, and you can add a photo too, something that appears there. You can see that I've just got kind of the shadow figure there at the top. I'm going to click Add Photo, and I'm going to choose a photo from my library right here. And you don't have to actually use a picture of yourself. You can do something cool like that. And now people will see you in high scoreboards represented by that photo and represented by your name listed there under the I am on the screen. So now let's look inside a Game Center. So this is stuff about you, and then you can look and see I don't have any friends listed here yet. I can look, I don't have any games listed here yet, but what's going to happen is it's going to bring up this screen here of suggestions of games. I can look at any challenges. This is where I would see friends that have challenged me, and this is where I would see requests for people that want to friend me on Game Center. So let's go into a Game Center game here. I'm going to go into one of my own games here, 40 Thieves. 40 Thieves Solitaire has Game Center high scores, so I can play it. And then very quickly here I can see I've scored just a minimum score there of 5. So I'm going to hit submit right away, submit to Game Center, and it will then say score submitted, and different games will do it in different ways. And I can now look here and see top scores for this game today, this week, all time in the leaderboards there. And I can look, and if I scroll all the way to the bottom there I can see me 5 points. So let's get some friends so I can challenge somebody to a game. I'll go to friends here and I'm going to hit the plus button at the top left. And then I'm going to enter in here at the top an Apple ID or a nickname of a friend and then invite them. So there's my Real Game Center account nickname there, and I'm going to send that off. And then my real account on my iPhone, in this case, is going to get the request. So my iPhone, I accept that invitation there. And you can see right away, instantly, on my iPad, I actually get a link there to that other account. So imagine this is your friend here. And I can see I have one friend listed on the left, and I can see information when they're selected on the right about what games they play and what their high scores are. Now here I am back in the game, and let me go to take a look at my score here again. And then now you can see Challenge Friends is lit up. I can select it because I have a friend, and I can challenge Gary Rosenzweig there to beat my score. And I can send that off, and that'll arrive there. So it's a fun way to challenge friends, send scores back and forth. So you don't have to compete against the whole world. You can compete against a single friend, or you can compete against just your group of friends. Here you can see at the top there's the friends leaderboard, and see I haven't played just Solitaire or 40 Thieves Solitaire today, but all time you can see there I have played it and registered a score of 120 points. So I can worry about competing against my group of friends rather than competing against all 434 players that have played 40 Thieves Solitaire. In addition to scores, another aspect of Game Center is our achievements. Achievements are single goals that you can reach in various types of games. Maybe reaching a certain level or obtaining a certain object, things like that. So that's another thing that you get with a lot of games in Game Center, and another reason you should sign up for it. In the end, there's really no reason not to sign up for Game Center. You already have an Apple account, so this just adds an extra aspect to it, and it allows some of the games you have to have more aspects to them, because you can challenge friends, you can get achievements, and all sorts of things like that. Matter of fact, some games won't work very well at all without Game Center, because the whole point is to achieve scores or get achievements in Game Center. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything, and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.